force are my people that are in jail, my people that couldn't make it, you know, my people that left the earth way too early. So these people are my why. And that's why whenever I do like events and I speak, I say I carry about 1,000 caskets behind me. You see, because obviously because of the life that I lived, I lost a lot of friends. You know that whole drug dealing in the hood, like, it's not cool, isn't it? It's not cool. And that's why I do what I do. I mentor, I go to prisons, I speak to the prisons and say, just because you are locked up doesn't mean that your aspirations have to be locked up too. You know what I'm trying to say? And yeah, so it's the people that are not on earth anymore. I just do it for them, really. Because they don't have the chance to do it anymore, right?
Literally, you know,
my people in jail, they don't have the chance to do it. So that's why they call me the voice of the voiceless.
Wow.
I say how it is. And
how did you make the transition? Because I know for a lot of people, it's hard thing to do, because a lot of people get stuck in this cycle where, like, they know that they want to change, they want to do stuff, they want to, you know, become better, give back or give of themselves. They know that they can be so much more, but it's like they're stuck in the, I want to say, stuck in the trap.
Stuck in the trap for real. You know, with me, it's funny because now, obviously, you have a lot of people that are motivational speakers. You have YouTube where you can just type in names and motivate yourself. But with me, I just had to accept myself.
Okay.
So to anyone out there, the reason why you're not moving forward is because you haven't, you know, forgiven yourself. You see? So I had to realize that I had to lose myself to find myself, to recreate myself. Losing myself when I was around my people, doing what I do because of them, you know, finding myself, understanding that I need me time. Still, you see what I'm saying?
I'm finding that out now, only now. Like,
listen, but that's what I'm saying. I believe in this life, yeah, something has to happen to you,
yeah,
in order for you to understand what I'm saying to you now.
Yeah, it's true.
A lot of people will just listen right now and be like, I don't know.
I hear that, yeah.
Like, okay, yeah, cool, but I don't know what you're talking about. But once you hit rock bottom, everything that I'm spitting, you go back and you be like, oh, okay, Mr3YourMind,
this is what he was saying.
This is what he was saying. You see? So that's why the people that will really feel me are the people that have been through pain. You know, so that's why I don't sugarcoat about certain things. I just say it how it is. Yes, I've been broke. Yes, I had suicidal thoughts. Yes, I lost my best friend and I thought to myself, why am I not dead? You see? But then I realized that, listen, everyone has a purpose. Everything on this earth has a purpose. So once you start thinking that way, then you just transition bit by bit. And that's why I say, I transform from pain into power and found my purpose. It's all about forgiving yourself, man. Facts.
I know that, obviously, you've talked about your transitional journey.
Yeah.
How do you kind of like stay on that road of transformation? Because there are certain things that, you know, like you'll feel it and it will really knock you back.
Yes.
A little bit. So what do you kind of do in those kind of situations? Because there's a lot of people who are just like, I've been through like pain, but this one is too painful. Like, how do I now get up from this?
Good question. Thing? Good question. You see, with that, I always believe in what you're praying for. You see, whenever we pray for something, I feel like we're just praying for the sake of praying. And then when it actually happens, you're like, oh my God.
So like, it shocks you.
You know, I'm there. Like, you know, my prayers are actually real.
Yeah.
So with me, all you need to know is, why are you praying to God? The devil is yes as well, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So while you go in towards your goals and towards your purpose, know that there will be obstacles that you need to learn to jump over. So back in the days when things used to happen to me, I used to say, oh, why me? But now I changed it to try me. Try me, man. You know, I didn't come this far to come this far. That's how I see it, you see? So imagine me now saying, after every obstacle I'm stopping, I'm not just letting myself behind. I'm letting the people that are looking up to me. You see what I'm saying? So with that, I say, I'm a prayerful person, you see. I know some people say God, Allah, Buddha, whatever your source is, make sure you stay connected. You know, make sure you have time so you can go to your source and charge yourself. You know, like, refocus, reshift and realign yourself. And that's what I do every day. Every day I take like 5 minutes. You don't have to do like an hour or anything crazy. And just appreciate how far you've come. That's it, because I believe why a lot of people are facing depression, anxiety, and they're too scared to move on is because they're thinking too much of where they want to go rather than how far they have come.
You
see what I'm saying? Because while you're going through that situation, you just think, oh, I can't do this no more. But as soon as you come out, you forget about the situation that you've been through.
Yeah, it's true.
Because everyone that's listening right now, or everyone that's like me and you, we've been through certain things where we thought, you know what, I'm done. Like, life is definitely on top of me, you know? Why is this happening to me? Like, all these, like, this is painful. Like, God, if you love me, like, what's going on? These are the questions I was asking myself. But then I thought to myself, you know what? If it's easy, I don't want it anyways. You know? Because everyone will jump on.
It's true.
You see what I'm saying? Everyone will just jump on it. So, you know what? I hear you, God. I'm praying for a better life. Cool. You know? When you pray for rain, you have to expect mud. But people pray for rain and expect rainbows straight away. That's not life, man. So that's how I see it. So that's why nothing can faze me, man. Nothing. I'm not, like, listen, if you're human and you're trying to, I'm not scared of it. You know what I'm saying? Like, so, yeah, that's my mindset, man.
Yeah.
You know?
That's a good mindset to
have. It took time. It took me 31 years to have this mindset.
Wow. You know,
and that's what people have to understand. It took me 31 years to be 31.
It's true.
You understand?
It takes time. It's not overnight.
It's not overnight. So to all my people that want to live and rush and do things quickly, listen, your deadline and God's deadline are two different deadlines. You know?
Completely.
So if you get, so you see what I'm saying? So if you say to yourself, oh, by 24, I wanted to have a kid, be married. Listen, maybe God wanted you to have a few guys or a few girls in order for you to find yourself. You see, get broken, get back up, and understand that you need to know your self-worth.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's deep.
So, yeah. You know, we're going deep. We're going
deep
today. Yeah.
Wow. How do you kind of balance, I wouldn't say social media, but
yeah,
I would think of you as a public figure. How do you balance that and kind of like real life? Do you think there's like a separate, it's like you separate work from like everyday life, or
You see, with me, this is what I just recently got to learn. You see, when I used to say I'm a loyal guy, I was lying. I was lying. See, let me elaborate on that before people think, what's he talking about?
What's he saying?
Because you see, when we talk about loyalty, a lot of people refer to being loyal to other people. But if you're loyal to other people and you're not loyal to yourself, you're not loyal at all. You understand what I'm saying to you? So with everything that I do, I make sure that I find a balance, but I also give 100%. And that's why I said I was never really loyal, because for something that I want to do, I give it my all. But if I have to do something for someone, I'm 50-50.
Half-hearted.
My guy, if that's the case, you're not 100%.
Yeah.
You're not loyal. You see what I'm trying to say? Wow. So with me, it's like, okay, I know between 9 and 12, I'm not going to go on my WhatsApp. That's the time for me and my son. He's just woken up. You know, I just want to do the nappies. Let the missus rest. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. Things there. Okay, between 12 and 2, that's me time. That's when I'm reading. You know, between 2 and 4, that's when I got training with my students. So, you know what I mean? I pattern everything in a way. A lot of people wake up like they're an accident. They don't plan that day. We're going deep.
Yeah.
We're going deep. You know, a lot of people just wake up. Oh, what should I do today? Oh, it's locked down anyways. You can't do nothing, right?
Mm.
I just chill. Okay. What's going on? Oh, Netflix. Come on, let's watch a few episodes.
Wow.
If you live your life like that, then trust me, you'll walk through life casually.
Yeah.
And if you walk through life casually, you end up a casualty, man. Simple. You know what I mean? Like, just have to say it how it is. So, yeah. You know, that's how I find the balance. Everything that I do, give 100% straight. No 50-50.
And I think that I find when you, like you were saying before, purpose, when you know, like, what you kind of want to get out of something, you would kind of only accept what it takes to get there.
First of all, right?
Who you are would kind of determine, like, what you're going to take and what you're going to not take. Because, you know, a lot of people get into the trap of, like you said, not being loyal to themselves, and it just reflects badly on them. It will take a lot out of you.
Absolutely.
for no reason.
Exhausting.
Like, because you didn't know, like, where you wanted to be, you didn't know who you wanted to be. So it's like, you, like, say for example, with like girls, I'm a girl, so
yeah,
I can talk
for girls. Talk for the girls.
So say for example, you didn't really know what you wanted in a guy.
Yeah.
And then you kind of just was just like, oh yeah, guys, like, oh, guys are the same basically.
Yeah. Yes.
Guys, like,
yes.
I just want to go out with someone. That's when you'll be kissing a thousand frogs. You'll just be kissing all these frogs.
Come on.
Because you didn't kind of know what you want. That's when you'll start saying those, you see the girls that say, oh, men are trash, this and that and the other. Like, it's because they don't really have a, they have a kind of like an aesthetic goal, like what they want, a guy with the beard that connects, they want a tall guy, they want dark, they want this, that, yeah, they want that, but in terms of like who they actually want as like a life partner, they haven't really figured that out. And sometimes they kind of have figured that out, but the person that they think that they want is not conducive with who they are.
Facts.
Basically, so
100%. Because you see, you saying that, yeah, I was just thinking of something, because a lot of females, you know, because I have a lot of mentees that are girls as well, they don't know the difference between them being attached or in love. Do you understand?
So what's the difference?
You see, the difference between you being attached to someone is that person can treat you anyhow, but because you're attached to him, because of maybe the way he's, you know what I mean, sleeping with you, and the way, you know what I'm saying, the way he just touches you.
Passion.
Passion. You understand? Passion. You know, you'd be like, oh my God, I love him. Now you're attached, babe. You don't love him. You know, but when you love that person, you respect yourself first. You're not scared to tell that person, listen, I want you to fix up. You're being a bum. I feel like I'm paying so much. Listen, just be straightforward. You understand? Our girls nowadays are scared to be like that, because they think, if I raise my voice, he might leave. Listen, you left yourself already before he left you.
Wow.
You understand? It gets deep. It gets deep. You left yourself already before he left you. So what he's doing right now, he's done it already. So that's why I always say, I'm very tough about self-love. You know, love yourself. Learn to be by yourself. You know, you being by yourself doesn't mean that you're alone. It doesn't mean that you're lonely. It means that you're working on yourself. You understand? And that's the same for the mandem as well. Because now you want to be on Instagram. If you're not on Instagram, you want to be around people. If you're not around people, you want to be around family. So where do you find time for yourself? There's none there, you see?
Wow.
So yeah, with that, I had to learn the hard way as well, because I was that type of guy that always wanted to be around people. Because I didn't want to face reality. Because when you're alone, you think. You don't want to think. Right?
True.
That's what it is. You don't want to think. So you think of all the changes that you want to create, and but you want to have changes without changing. So because of that, you're thinking, nah, I need to be around people. Or let me go on social media. Hey guys, do you want to come around? Should we go and drink? Let's go and get yacht so I can forget about reality for 4 hours.
Wow.
And that's why a lot of guys just like to drink and go out. Not for the simple fact to just go and see girls, but they just want to escape reality. You see it?
Wow.
And when I say all these things, I'm talking about myself. Just drink yourself away, man. Let's forget about life for a second. You know, blame it on the juice if you do something mad. Let's be real. You know what's going on. You know what's going on. So all the people that are like, I was so drunk, I didn't know. Or is it? Okay, you didn't know. But you were so drunk, you didn't know. But you didn't know that you done something. But you were so drunk, right?
Wow.
Okay. Listen. You know what I'm saying? Like, what are you saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? So with that, it's all about, you know, self-worth. Once you know your self-worth, no one can come and tell you nothing, bro.
Wow. And even with that, like, it can even be something as like, for me, it's I have a problem. I have a problem with excessive helping.
Okay.
Like, say for example, like, someone wants me to do something.
Yeah.
To say no is a problem, because I'm just like, if I don't do this for someone, they'll die. Like, if I don't one will do it for them. Like,
okay.
And then I'll like burn myself out trying to like help here. And it's like, I had to kind of this is very recent, be like, okay, so what about myself, kind of thing. Like, that's where your aspect of self-love came in. And it's not a bad thing to help people. It's not a bad thing to share with people and give to people. But when you're depleted, it's like,
no, listen, and this is what it is. Do you know what the problem is with that? Do you know what you're teaching people? You're teaching people that they come first and you come second. Straight away. You know, you're a people's person. You're like me. You know, when you do things, you do it because you want to do it.
Yeah.
You understand? But the thing with that, I'm not saying that people are bad, but the thing with that is people kind of push your emotions away. And they're calling and be like, oh, S, do you know? Oh, how are you doing, first of all?
Yeah.
Okay, listen now, yeah? You know what I'm saying? And you're there like, you're just taking everything in.
Yeah.
But who are you talking to when you need to about something? You see?
Wow.
So with that, like, it's not selfish if you do things for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
It's not selfish for you to say no to someone, because you saying no to someone, you're saying yes to yourself.
Mm.
You're saying yes to that person, you say no, no to yourself.
So basically all this time I've been saying no, no, no.
You say no, 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 wow. Really. You see what I'm trying to say? But because you don't want to look bad, or because you feel like, oh, if I don't do this and if I need them, then, nah, listen, if people do things for you because you've done something for them, that's business.
Yeah, yeah.
You understand? If they do it because it's coming from your heart, that's, listen, it's love. So you will see the right people. Even if I ask you something and you can't do it, I'll be like, you know what, I understand. But why do I understand? Because I understand myself.
Yeah.
You see it? But most people don't even understand themselves. So when you say no, it's like, oh, is it? Yeah? All right, cool.
Yeah. But I always have this thing where I feel like people are going to react like that. Like, oh, yeah, okay, so I see how you can't help me.
But if it's like that, it's easier for you.
It's true.
Then you will know how to, you know what I'm saying? It's like sugar and salt. You don't know what sugar and salt is unless you taste it.
It's true.
You see what I'm going to say? So maybe you have to do something to see how someone is react to be like, cool.
I'll
put you there. Yeah?
True.
And for the real ones to just be like, oh, come on, I know, man. Your mommy did it. You know what I'm saying? So don't feel bad. Don't feel bad for what you want to do.
It's recently that I'm just like,
whatever.
Yeah. Recently.
Come on.
And I feel like when you finally figure out like who you are and certain places where you want to get, people are just like, right, you've changed. I'm just like, no.
Do you understand?
I haven't changed.
No. This is the maddest thing. I was actually talking about at one podcast that my friend was doing.
Okay.
He's like, yeah, so Mr3YourMind, what do you think about change? And I was like, what's there to think? I said, what's there to think? Listen, in life, you have to change.
Yeah.
Don't let just your number, your age change. Oh, I'm 33 this year, I'm 34 this year. No. End of the day, if you want to climb up, you can't live the same life that you were living before in order to get to where you need to get to.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Definitely.
So the people that understand you and that love you, they'll be like, you know what? Let her go do her thing. And I know she'll come back and help others up as well.
Mm-hmm.
But the people that actually don't know what they're doing with themselves, they feel like, oh, you're leaving me now, yeah? Or you're better now, yeah?
Oh.
Okay, I see you. So this is where you have to be very careful, because holding on sometimes hurts more than letting go.
Mm.
And the reason sometimes why you're not moving forward is because of your people, them.
Mm-hmm.
It's because of your family members.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but it's my cousin, though. Yeah, but it's my best friend, though. Listen, some of your day ones been hating you since day two, man.
Definitely.
You see what I'm trying to say? But nowadays, you know, the devil has another way of saying, I need you, by saying, I love you. You know I got you.
Mm.
You know you can trust me. You know? And that's why sometimes when you're praying for something, but you tell someone, the devil has access to you. Yeah.
Some other girl was actually talking about that on Instagram. I can't even remember her social media handles. I would have dropped it. But she was like,
yeah,
a lot of people that you're trusting have like evil eye. Like they don't really, they're not really happy for you.
No, they're just
smiling to you so that they can go and be like, okay, so this is what you want to do. Yeah.
100%. It's like, oh, is it? This is what you want to do. Oh, yeah, I got you. Some of them, when they say I got you, they mean I got you. Watch, I got you.
Wow.
Like, you see, I got you. And that's why it comes to something that I always say. You know the word, I believe in you.
Yeah.
You know, it actually has two meanings.
Oh, really?
It's a mad thing. But it's only two meanings to the people that understand life.
Okay.
So when I say I believe in you, yeah, that's the first meaning that everyone knows.
I believe
in you, I'll push you. Listen, you're great, let's go. And then we have other types of people that say, I believe in you.
Mm.
Meaning, once you level up, once you change, once I see you going closer to the light, once I see you finding your purpose, I'll believe in you.
Wow.
You understand?
Yeah.
So some people are like, I don't understand why they're leaving me. What have I done? Like, I haven't done anything. No, darling. They told you from early, once you level up, they'll believe in you.
Mm.
But you thought it's the first bit of, I believe in you. No. You see what I'm trying to say?
That's
so
crazy.
Listen, you always have to, you know what I mean?
Wow.
Ah, we're going deeper, man.
Yeah. Gosh.
The way you said, oh gosh, it's like, oh, I'm not ready.
Listen,
we're going deeper.
The thing
deeper.
Is, I'm ready, but it's just like, you know when certain things just click, like,
yes.
I've been ready.
Listen, 100%.
But it's like, oh gosh, when you're intentional about certain things, yeah. Like, for example, like where you want to go and everything, like you always find that like people are just they behave like nonsense. I'm not gonna lie.
100%. Listen.
And me, I'm someone that I hate. I hate directional nonsense. Like, so, I hate when someone is just like disrespectful or so. Because, like, I feel like for me, I'm some the type of person when someone is to like disrespect me,
yeah,
I get very alpha. Like, I'm just like,
okay.
You're not about to destroy everything that I just built. Like, you're not like, what are you doing, basically? But then it's like, now I've learned to kind of like channel it into my work, so to speak.
Perfect.
So
listen, that's the best way, because let me tell you something, people can only draw you out once they have your attention.
Yeah.
Listen, it's like me coming to you and saying, oh, look at you, man. What, you think you're sick because what, you're 5'2"? What am I talking about?
Yeah.
I can't draw you out. You're not talking about me.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
What, oh, this guy, beardless guy, look at him. If people know how to trigger your emotions, they'll just control you like a remote. You understand? So that's what I'm saying. Like, with me, whatever you say, listen, I've trained my mind so much, yeah, it's that it doesn't affect me. Ghana, you call me uncle, you know what I'm saying? What do you mean, what? It's like, yeah, what? What are you saying? You're looking at me. So initially, I wanted to be like, listen, are you mad? Yeah. Like, what?
Yeah.
But then I looked at him and I saw myself. I was like, you know, he's coming from a place of insecurity. So I looked at him and said, my brother, there's nothing wrong, you know. I was actually looking at you because I thought your drip was hard. So I could see he was losing up, saying, oh, is it, yeah? I say no more. I said, you know, I said, he was being very calm, and I said, so why did you feel that? Why do you feel like I was rushing you, attacking you? He's like, do you know what it is? Because all my life, people were always attacking me. So whenever people looking at me, I just straight away think it's on.
Wow.
Straight away. So what you were saying is totally right, man. People are facing themselves. Trauma.
Me.
Jeez. Trauma for real.
Oh gosh.
You know, so yeah, man, it's peak.
But I feel like other people, like everyone's, you know, gone through their own level of trauma. Yeah. But I feel like sometimes when people have gone through trauma, they now traumatize you because it's like, almost like, shit, have some, basically.
Yeah, have, so have too much, have some, you know? And that's what it is. This is what I mean about people. People are more, like, people want, how should I say it so everyone will understand what I'm saying? People want to make sure that you feel that pain more than that vulnerability. You understand? Because when you show that you're vulnerable, it's seen as, oh, he's weak.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, you're not mandem. What's wrong with you being soft?
Oh, no.
What's going on? But then I realized that because I spend so much time with myself, yeah, understanding, learning about myself, I realized that you have to be vulnerable in order for you to level up and come out yourself. You see what I'm trying to say? So with this one, again, it's like you have to be by yourself, but to also learn to forgive yourself. It comes back to what I said in the beginning. Because it's easy for us to forgive other people and say, oh, I forgive you. Yeah, I forgive you. Yeah, that's fine. But have you forgiven yourself for what you put yourself through?
That's difficult.
Difficult, man. And with that, again, it's a process.
And even that, you have to kind of, you know, be shown what you've done to yourself. Because some of the things that you've done to yourself, you've taken it so normal that you don't even realize it was the wrong thing.
Yes. Exactly, and that's what's happening to a lot of these youngsters nowadays. They're so
desensitized.
It's crazy. It's crazy. Like when I speak to some of my mentees and they're like, I just said to Nankin, and I'm like, why? Oh, he said something in the group chat that I didn't like. What are you talking about, my guy? You're only 14. What are you talking about? You see, but it's because, again, they haven't got a good relationship with their family members. Family members always say, oh, look at you millennials, all you know is just being lazy. So they don't get these words of encouragement that will help them, you see? So it's like they say lost generation, but I feel like we've given up on them. And if they're the lost generation, what does it say about us? Because they're looking up to us.
True.
Right? So, yeah.
That's not...
It's peak. It's so peak. Yeah, that's what I do, You know, that's why I do the Free Your Mind Academy, and the actual meaning of free your mind and be free. So be free means be interconnected with your mind, body and soul.
Okay.
Yeah. And when I say free your mind, it means free your mind from insecurities, free your mind from yourself,
mm-hmm.
free your mind from distractions,
mm.
you know, because in this world it's you versus you, man. That's mm-hmm. how I see it.
Definitely
you versus, because when it, you see, when you go through that moment, you know, when family members pass away, it doesn't matter how many brothers, sisters, best friends you got. Yeah. Listen, you can be in the room with them but still feel alone.
Mm, true.
Facts.
True.
You know, and this is where it comes down to, wow, like, is this really me? Is this happening to me?
Mm-hmm.
All right, God, give me strength. Start speaking to yourself. Give me strength. Give me strength.
Mm, I speak to myself every day.
Every day, most of the
you
time.
Need to. Come on, you have to. Who's gonna speak to
you? Who's gonna speak to you? You need professional advice.
Yeah.
Come on.
Oh my gosh. Is,
yeah, man.
So getting into our topic, how to survive internally. What advice would you kind of give someone? First of all,
what advice would I give someone? How to
survive internally. Mm-hmm. First of all, what do you mean by that?
You see, when I say how to survive internally, yeah, let me tell you this quickly. You see, when I say you can be a public success, but you can be a private failure.
Mm.
You see that?
It's true.
Yeah?
It's true.
You see that? People see me online, social media. Oh, Mr3YourMind. Oh, he's such a great guy. It's of course it's easy to be great. Right. You know what I'm saying? Come on. Now it's easy to be great when people are watching you.
Yeah.
It's easy to know what to say when you know you're on the spot.
Mm-hmm.
It's about what you do when no one is watching you.
Yeah.
Do you understand?
Definitely, yeah.
It's about how you see yourself when no one else is watching you. Yeah? And this is what I mean by surviving internally. You have to feed yourself by watching motivational videos, whatever, mm-hmm. read books. You have to feed yourself daily.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not just talking about reading or watching videos. Speaking life into yourself.
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
You know what I mean? Say to yourself, I love me. You know, I appreciate me. Show mm-hmm. gratitude. Because we learn how to show love to other people. Definitely. Oh, you look so beautiful. You look so good. Okay, how do you look though?
It's true.
You know what I'm saying? Like, do you look in the mirror and say, I look good?
Mm.
No, because it's seen as, oh, you think you're too good.
Yeah.
But if you don't think that you're too good, who else should come and say you're too good?
Mm.
And this is where it comes down to, how is your other half? What do you mean other half? So basically, that means I'm a half as well then.
Basically.
You understand what I'm saying to you? Nah, B, I'm a full person.
Wow.
And that's what people have to understand. Like, don't rely too much on I need to find a husband, I need to find a wife, I need to find a partner, I need to find... You need to find yourself, man.
Definitely.
But in order for you to do that, let me give you an advice. Every morning when you wake up, write 3 things down that you're grateful for,
mm-hmm.
and 3 things that you thought you could never come back from.
Mm.
3 things that happened to you and you thought, that's it, it's done.
Mm-hmm.
Write it, and after that, just read it over and over again.
Wow.
And once you do that, realize that you are here now.
Mm.
Realize that you're here now. That's the first stage, I would say,
mm-hmm.
in surviving internally.
Wow.
Understand the power of now. You can't live in the past. You can't live in the future.
Definitely.
Your now is your past. Your now is your future. You see what I'm trying to say? So
mm-hmm.
just understand where you're standing right now, and then we go to the next step.
Wow.
Mm.
Understanding now is very, very, very important.
Listen.
Because there's certain things, like, I feel like, for me, like, not the thing that is like the greatest thing that ever happened to me in life, but I feel like one of the biggest turning points in my life as an adult was like having my kids. And I feel like after I had my kids, it was almost like my life was running like I don't know how to explain it. Everything was like, from like, I had my first child, well, I got pregnant when I was 22.
Mm.
Then it's like I was saying to someone, I can't remember if it was on Snap or where it was,
yeah,
that those years until now just feels like, you know, the bit of the alphabet that goes LMNOP. That's what it feels like.
Yeah, yeah.
It just went so fast, and it's almost like I was living so blasé, like, so, you know, like, not that I didn't know where I wanted to get to, but because I was so like, oh, the past, oh, yes, I need my future. But then in the present, I forgot to kind of live in my present.
Yes.
You get what I'm saying? Yes, so man. It's like, I'm dwelling on things that happened in the past. and I'm thinking, oh my gosh, like, what about my future? But not really realizing that my future is as you know, it's as, I don't know what to say, as frequent as, yes, like the next minute.
Yes, exactly.
You get what I'm saying? 100. So I'm there dwelling on, oh my gosh, like yesterday, or what I did yesterday, da, da, oh my gosh, I need to get to tomorrow, da, da, da. But yeah, like a second after, 2 minutes after, 3 minutes after, that's also my future. So the more that I'm kind of dwelling on the past and the future, the present is kind of getting lost. And I feel like that's where people, you know, they lose their way, because yes, they're so, you know, they're 100%. Either in their past or they're either in their future. They're never in their present.
Exactly that. Because with that, that's what I'm saying. Because you're thinking too much of, oh, why did I do this last week? Why did I do this yesterday?
Mm.
Why are you doing all this, yeah? Your present moment is going and going and going and going. Next thing you see is tomorrow already.
Mm.
It's the next day already. So now you didn't really have time to show gratitude that you're still alive, you're healthy, your kids are good,
mm-hmm,
because you're worried about bills. Listen, bills. I always say, boy, listen,
adulthood is a scam. It's a scam. It's big
a,
one.
Hey, listen, it's mad, isn't it? It's a mad thing. Like, listen, but this is what I always say. Listen, we all have more bills than money, more problems than good things. But end of the day, concentrate on what you can change.
Mm.
The things that you can't change, leave them to God, man.
Like, definitely.
Why are you stressing? You understand? Like, what's the point of... That's why when you try to call me, you try to talk about things that happened to you last year and that. I'm cool, but how do you feel now? Now. No, let's talk about now. Yeah, but like, I don't really care about that person anymore. That was last year. But so why are you talking about it now then? You see it? Yeah, but no, I don't care about them. Come on, man. I haven't seen them for 6 months. You haven't seen them, but in your mind, you see them every day. Because you mentioned it right now.
True.
See it?
Mm-mm.
So, yeah, man, listen, we just have to learn to let go.
Mm-hmm,
let go, man.
Wow.
Let go. Yeah.
That is nuts. Recently, on social media, there's a I want to say influencer. Mm. I'll say public figure again. There's a public figure.
Come on.
Called Derek Jackson. I'm not sure if you know of him.
No.
Well, basically, he's kind of like a motivational... I would call him a motivational speaker.
Okay.
And he advocates for men and good men and kind of calls out like... men cheating, men with like behavior disorders, like why you shouldn't go out. Yeah, relationship advice. Yeah. So recently, I'm not sure if you heard about the news that he was unfaithful to his wife. And a lot of people kind of like stigmatized him and was just like, oh, you were condemning, like, even like from rappers to like pastors, you were condemning them and you were there doing ABMC. You're doing that as well, like,
you see,
how do you have any view on it, first of all?
Yes, the thing is, like, let's be real, you see, and this is what I'm saying, and please, everyone here, listen to me carefully. I'm not scared of being judged. He's only human. You understand? He's only human. As soon as another human is sinning differently to you, it's easy for you to point the fingers at them. Oh yeah, but you have a wife and da-da-da-da-da. The only thing I would say, the only thing I would say is he shouldn't have attacked that pastor the way he did.
Yeah.
That made it worse.
Yeah.
You see what I'm trying to say? And no, you should know better. And your wife is your queen.
Mm-mm.
You were talking like you're highly...